All right, good evening, everyone. Today's service is going to be a wonderful but informal Christmas Eve service, mostly retelling the story and singing some of the Christmas songs that remind us about the whole reason we're here. It's good to see you all. It's a great time of year to gather those dear close by and celebrate God's light coming into the world. It is no coincidence that we celebrate it this time of year, for technically, this is the darkest time of year. It is the time of year when we'll see the least sun in a given day, and most of our days are, well, in darkness. But it is a reminder that even at our darkest moments in life, God's light shows through. So let's start her off with our first song, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Some of you know this prayer. We're going to spend most of our time in the service singing, so if you want to stand to sing, you certainly are welcome to. You're going to be, I'm not going to make you jump up and down. The readings will be kind of short eventually, so here we go. With feeling. So go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Lowly manger, our humble Christ was born, and God sent us salvation in that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Time. Go tell it on the tell you really quickly about what's coming up for our regular Sunday service. We'll not be here in 2 days because obviously we're here for Christmas. We'll take the weekend off, and next week we'll come back all normal. Remember, our worship service these days is a neat little mix between a regular worship service and sitting down talking about our faith and our lives and things like that. It's kind of neat. And so a couple things though to pray about in our midst that want to keep our own Jane Reinke in our prayers, who was taken to the hospital today, and I'll give you updates on that as time goes on. And let's keep our own Jennifer Hansen, who's had a number of issues with pain, in our prayers as well. Others we'd like to lift up in our prayers this evening. In that case, let us pray. Dear God, we have come together today shining a light into the darkness. Help us remember that even in our darkest times, Jesus comes and God's light shines through. Keep us close together that we can be a source of support for each other. For those of us who are weak, please give strength. For those of us who are lonely, please remind us that we are there for one another. And help us to be ambassadors of your love. In Jesus' name, we lift these and so many more prayers in this blessed season. Amen. All right. We remind ourselves every time we come together for worship that Jesus came to teach us many things, but the most important thing was about forgiveness. Forgiveness of ourselves and forgiveness for other people. And so we remind ourselves, especially on this Christmas time, about forgiveness. This wonderful quote, Christmas is not merely, or not just a time for festivity and merrymaking. It is more than that. It is a time for contemplation of eternal things. The Christmas spirit is a spirit of giving and forgiving. And remembering not only God's forgiveness of us, but forgiving other people and keeping them close, because keeping a grudge hurts not only them, but us as well. Let us pray. Oh God, we come to you this evening thanking you so much for the birth of Jesus. We ask you to remind us about the gift given to all of us of forgiveness, and help us to share that with the world around us. And let us continue our prayers in silence. Brothers and sisters, hear the good news. Wonderful quote from the Gospel of Luke, from Jesus. Forgive the ones who say they are sorry. Even if one of them mistreats you 7 times in 1 day and says, I'm sorry, you should still forgive that person. This is a season of remembering those close to us and a season of forgiveness. I think I can make it now. The pain is gone. All of those bad feelings have disappeared. Here is the rainbow I've been praying. Service is going to be a time of retelling the Christmas story through both words and music. So we'll spend most of our time either listening to words or singing. So and remember at the end, that candle you hold in your hand is going to be really handy. We're going to kill all the lights in this room, and we're just going to one by one share the candlelight and sing Silent Night. And it's a beautiful reminder of that light shining out in the darkness. Our first song. Infant Holy, Infant Lowly, as we begin our retelling of that very first Christmas so long ago.
Infant Holy, Infant Lowly, Lord is bed a cattle stall, oxen lowing, little knowing, Christ the babe is Lord of all.
Emperor of Rome was counting people. In Palestine, which was part of the Roman Empire, everyone had to pay taxes, sums of money that helped pay for the army or for the building of towns and roads. So the emperor was working out how much he could expect to be paid. By adding up the number of people living there, it was quite a business. And everyone had to record their names in the place where they were born. And those who had moved away had to go all the way back to be counted. And the roads were full of men and women walking from one place to another. Now a carpenter named Joseph and his fiancée Mary were doing just that. They had come all the way from Nazareth along the river Jordan to Bethlehem. It was a long journey. And Mary was riding on a donkey. It was not a good time for her to travel. She was expecting a baby, a very special baby. The angel had told Mary that she was to be the mother of God's Son, the most blessed baby ever born. Let's sing together, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Cast down our sin and
no room at the inn. For Bethlehem was crowded when they arrived. Mary and Joseph were tired and hungry after their long journey. So was the donkey. They went straight to the inn to rest. "I'm sorry," said the innkeeper, "but there's no room. I've been full with visitors for days." No room. Joseph was really worried. They had to stay somewhere. Mary's baby was due at any moment. And by late evening, the best they could find was a stable. And the owner could see that they were desperate. So he moved his animals into one stall and gave Mary and Joseph the other. Please join with me in Away in a Manger. And later, in the glow of lamplight, Mary's special baby was born. She called him Jesus, as the angel had told her to do. This time of service, I'm going to ask Cassie and Patty to come on up and help me with the song, Mary, Did You Know? I'm going to sneak on off here, because I'm just backing up on guitar. I'm not really doing anything particularly important. So grab the chair, my dear, for Patty, and the microphone's right here. Enough rope? Awesome.
No, we would not let you hang yourself.
No, not quite enough of that, Patty. You're all good. You're going to need this? I take it. Mm-hmm. All right. Anything else I can get you?
I have my copies there, too.
All right.
I got yours. Thank you so much.
Awesome. I'll just sit back here and behave myself and play guitar, then. All right.
You don't mind being a 50.
No, not at all. I'm your 50. It's all good.
Is your mic on, Daddy? Yep. Okay.
Speaking of your mic, make sure it works.
It works.
Wonderful. Take it from the top, kids. Ready?
Thank you.
Now there were shepherds in the hills around Bethlehem that night looking after their sheep. It was a cold, clear night. The shepherds wrapped their cloaks around themselves and kept a sharp lookout for wild animals. All was dark and quiet and still. And suddenly they were surrounded by a brilliant light. It was as if the sun and moon were shining together on the very spot where they were sitting. It frightened the shepherds, I can tell you. They had never known anything like it. And then a voice spoke out of the brightness. It was an angel. "Do not be afraid," said the angel, "for I have good news for you. A king has been born in Bethlehem, and the baby is your Savior, Christ the Lord. Go and see him for yourselves." The shepherds could hardly believe their ears. They stared at each other in wonder. "And you will find the baby wrapped warmly and lying in a manger," said the angel, who knew they were astonished. And as soon as the angel had spoken, the shepherds heard voices singing praises to God, and the whole sky seemed to be singing. And then the light dimmed, and the voices faded into the night, and the shepherds stared up at the stars. But the angel had gone, and all was quiet again. Sing with me, "Angels We Have Heard on High."
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plain, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain.
Shall see stay, oh, Lord.
go to Bethlehem at once," said the shepherds, remembering what the angel had told them. So they left their sheep and hurried over the fields to look for the newborn king. And when the shepherds got to the stable, they found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby Jesus lying in a manger. It was just as the angel had said. He was wrapped in clothes and looked snug in his little cradle of hay. For the Son of God had truly been born in a stable. Please join with me in the beautiful song, "What Child Is This?" Too. And they traveled all the way to Bethlehem on camels following a big bright star. And the star took them to the place where Jesus lay. And Mary and Joseph welcomed the travelers as they came to worship the royal child. And the wise men brought the baby precious gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, gifts fit for a king. For that was the very first Christmas more than 2,000 years ago.
Let anger and fear and hate disappear. Let there
shoulders asleep in their beds, in the eyes of young babies, their first fallen snow, elderly memories that never grow. Oh, let it be Christmas everywhere, let heavenly music fill the air, let every heart sing, let every bell ring, story of hope and joy and peace. Single candle, and one person lights their neighbors, and they light their neighbors, and so on and so forth, until the light of this place is merely the light that started with such a small candle. For Jesus came as a light in the darkness, and that darkness has not overcome the light. And just as we take a single candle and share it with one another, so too we can take the love that Jesus gives us and share that with one another until the world is filled with a light that lasts all year long. So we'll start with a simple think of this as the light that came to us in a little manger in Bethlehem so long ago. And that love we share one with another. Patty, I'm gonna light your candle. And I'm gonna ask you to light your neighbors, and so on and so forth, until all of our lights are lit. For the love we share with one another does not diminish, but rather grows with each person we share with.
So tender.
That was not my fault.